morning, everyone. New adventure today, searching for a comet. Ready to fly through the sky on a comet and conquer the Quidditch competition? Complete the caper with your Quidditch crew and earn a special new Quidditch move that you can only do on your new comet broom. Now we are getting a new broom. Remember how in the last Quidditch chapter we said that we need a new broom because our old one gave us a splinter? Well, now we're getting that broom. Good morning, and I think I've already said good morning. How are you all today? I hope you're doing well. I have not slept. I am up at 2:05 in the morning. Yeah, it's good. I am barely sleeping these days, man. I cannot. Just let's just go because I'm actually pretty excited for this one. Go to the Quidditch pitch. Let's go. Hogwarts mystery added this new snapshot mode now. And well, the snapshot mode will help me get some cutscenes, and it'll definitely help me capture cutscenes and I can capture cutscenes and all. It will help me in the videos and all, and backgrounds for drawings. Oh, Skye.
Oh.
Hey. Srahi, look what I've got. Is that a new broom?
Oh.
Not just any new broom. A brand new Comet 260 broom. Looks nice. My dad left it for me as a gift to congratulate me after winning our first house match. Oh, that's so awesome. That was rather thoughtful.
Oh.
Wait until you see what move I can do on the Comet 260. Yes, let's see what's so special about this broom. Mm-hmm. You don't already know what's special about comets? Perhaps not. You know, I've never had a broom of my own. Then let me tell you about this comet broom. Okay. I think the snapshot mode is supposed to work here too. Yeah, look. This will certainly help me like capture more cutscenes and all that. Because you know how I feel about cutscenes. I've never seen a brand new racing broom up close. We need speed to win our next house match. Good braking is a must. Comets have been around since 1929. At what year is this again? Comet Trading Company was started by two foul-mouthed Falcons Quidditch players. The smashing broom, just look at it. Yeah, it looks like it's made of gold, to be honest. This one. Oh. It's brass. You did tell me once that your dad and brothers like comet brooms. Cotton cage breaking. I am a little confusion, but you know what? Never mind. I like the snapshot mode. It'll definitely help. You know a lot about Comet Broom, Skye?
Uh-huh.
They're a Parkin family favorite. And Orion told us we'll be facing Gryffindor next. The fastest house is Hogwarts. Fastest house at Hogwarts. What am I saying?
Uh-huh.
Flying at high speeds, a breaking charm can make the difference between a win and a loss.
Oh.
And all Comet Brooms have a patented Horton cage breaking charm cast upon them. So how does it work? Is it that the Comet's breaking charm gives you more movement control?
Uh-huh.
Yes, let me show you that special move I was telling you about. The breaking charm makes it possible. Yes, let's see it. What are you doing? I don't get it. Skye, I don't get it.
Uh-huh.
Smashing, right? It's called broom drifting. Broom drifting. That sounds wrong. Broom drifting? When do you use it in a Quidditch match? See, I need to shake a few chasers off my trail.
Uh-huh.
I speed up, then break fast, drifting to the side so fast they'll fly on by before they know what's happened.
Oh.
You can broom drift on any comet broom, but that was the first I've tried on this broom. Smashing. It was quite a sight. What a great surprise, Skye.
Oh.
What? This isn't the surprise I called you here for. It is not. It's not. Srahi, do you really think I'm the kind of mate who'd call you here just to show off? Actually, yes, Skye, it's kind of in your nature, it's true. Yes, it's just like you to want to show off your Quidditch skills on a smart new broom. You're right, it is just like me. Guys, are you watching behind Skye? There is a puppy. There's a puppy with the Bobaton scarf. Guys, are you seeing this? Where'd the puppy go? Are you seeing this puppy? Okay, I'm not going to question it. This is like the annoying dog in Undertale, who's not actually that annoying actually. That being said, guys, please watch my Undertale video. I'm falling short of views, very short. But I'm having so much fun playing Undertale. But that would be wretched of me showing off a new comet while a shooting star is giving you splinters. My borrowed room is a bit of a bother. Yeah, there it is, the puppy again. Guys, there's a puppy. And I love puppies. And what is that crap doing? Yeah, never mind. Which brings me to my surprise for you. I'm listening. Now that I'll be playing Quidditch on a Comet 260, I won't be needing the Comet 220 I've sometimes been using. It's a Parkin family hand-me-down from my brothers to me. And now I'd like for you to have it, Sarahi. Oh my god, she's so sweet. A broom of my own and it's a Comet 220? You deserve it. You're a Quidditch chase of Hufflepuff now. You need a proper racing broom. A Comet will give you an advantage and that gives our house an advantage. Skye, this means so much. How can I ever thank you? Broom drift with me at practice today, that's how. Let's broom drift all the way to the Quidditch Cup. Now you're talking. Come on, you've got a Comet broom waiting for you in the changing room. I kind of want to wear something else, but I don't know what else to wear. Alright. I can't wait to practice Quidditch on a Comet broom of my own. Kya hua? What is it? What's wrong? Skye, what's wrong? It's gone. Gone? Left it right over there, leaning up against my cabinet. Perhaps it was moved? Let's look around. I don't get it. One thing, like in these lockers, the Quidditch uniform, it's blue and well, it's black or white when, you know. Did you look behind the blackboard? Are you sure you left the broom in here? A broom doesn't just disappear unless a Venusco has been cast upon it. I'll look behind the blackboard. Perhaps the broom got mixed in with these others? I'm this close to having my own Quidditch broom. Too many of these brooms look alike. This Comet broom has been in my family for years. It has history. The Comet 220 vanished just before it becomes your Comet 220. Suspicious. But how is it suspicious? You must have misplaced it or something. The Comet broom I wanted to give you is definitely not here. Oh my god, Skye has the anger baby face. Anger baby Skye. Perhaps it will turn up. We can look again after practice. It'll turn up all right. Got a hunch who took it. Took it? You think someone took the broom by mistake? I don't think it was a mistake. After practice, the two of us are getting your Comet broom. Until then, I'll get another sprinter with a shooting star. Am I supposed to do a friendly? Yeah, explain this to me. Like, why is it spawn properly over here, but over here I get this ugly thing? Anyway, yeah, I'm just gonna do this match and then, you know, because everybody's already seen me doing matches, I'm just gonna cut it out. Alright, match's over. Now what? Ravenclaw house? None of us are Ravenclaws. What are we doing? Why are we going Yes, I have several questions. And there are people here, by the way. Skye, there are people here. We are going to get so caught. Look, MC already looks worried. Now let's get your comment 220 off to the Ravenclaw. Why are we here? This is your plan, Skye. We can't just walk into another house's common room. I go wherever I want. Besides, everyone is at dinner except this bloke. Out, please. Move along now. Hey, you're not Ravenclaw. Yes, exactly. Uh-huh. And you're not a Quidditch star mate. Out, please. Skye Parkin? Are you serious? That's what I brought you. Get you my dad's autograph if you leave now and tell no one. An autograph from Victor Wanderer Ethan Parkin? Brilliant. Well, I suppose that worked. Skye, being the kid of a professional Quidditch player may get you some allowances in the Quidditch world. But we can't just walk into the Ravenclaw common room and kick out Ravenclaws.
Uh-huh.
Sure we can. We just did.
Oh my god.
Skye, I had to promise Ethan Parkin's autograph to several Ravenclaws today to get us in here. What are we even doing here? And what does this have to do with the missing comet room? I'm hungry. We have to find where Erika Rath has hidden it. Kuch bhi! How do you know Erika Rath took it, man? You think Erika Rath stole the comet room and hid it here? Right, and I'll tell you why we start searching. Isn't that like jumping to conclusions? Jumping to conclusions is a very big problem in MC's group. The statue knows something? What? Wow. The perspective is kind of cool. See? It's like this round perspective. So cool, yeah. I love this snapshot feature. You said Erika Rath stared you down at the pre-match party. Yeah, that's what she does, right? Rath is Hogwarts. Yes, I know. No. Look under the sofa. Rath and her Quidditch mate stared us down the great hall. We know. There aren't many places to hide Broom in here. Let's try not to break anything. Ooh, chess! This is boring, man. Can we just... Oh, yeah. I have to finish this. MC looks disappointed. The indoor common room is pretty. I'll give him that much. Where else? There are like so many books in here. They say that the Ravenclaw common room is like mini library. There is no way to search a room for a broom. But we've no proof that Rath even took the comic 220 from my changing room or that she hid it here. Mm-hmm. Srahi, Ravenclaw is the reigning Quidditch Cup champions.
Uh-huh.
And you joining our house team has made us the team to beat this year. Huh. So the last thing Rath would want is you having the advantage of better racing room. And what better place to hide it than the Ravenclaw common room where we're not supposed to be. But we don't know that Rath knows the missing common room is yours or that you plan to give it to me. We don't know that Rath doesn't know that. Okay, this is getting confusing. We don't know, they know that we don't know what is going on. Skye, this is not how one goes about solving a mystery, trust me, I know.
Uh-huh.
Perhaps not a cursed vault mystery, even she knows. Perhaps not a cursed vault mystery, but this is a Quidditch mystery. What's the difference? Still, when you're somewhere you shouldn't be and you don't find the thing you're searching for, it's time to leave. But we've only just begun to search. Times call for drastic measures. Drastic measures? Flipindo! You seriously scared MC? Skye scared MC. Like, awesome. Skye!
Oh.
It'll be faster to search this way. Let's flip everything in the room until we can... Until we uncover your comment group. Yeah, you just... No! No, we can't flip everything. We'll be caught for sure. Not if we're quick about it, we'll leave. If we leave here without the common broom, then Wrath wins. Oh my god, Skye. Skye, stop it. The broom isn't here. What in the world is that ruckus? I hear Professor Flitwick coming this way. Hold on, is that a broom bristle I see? That's literally just a bristle. Skye, we have to go now. Got the bristle, let's dash. Skye, what the freak? See, he knows. He knows. I'm just gonna... Yeah, this is like the equivalent of table flipping. And we are going to get a lot of gems for this. I like that. He knows, doesn't he? Hi, Professor Flitwick, you wanted to see me?
Oh.
Miss Parkin is on her way as well. I suppose you know why I've called you here. Damn it! I suppose it's not about our marks and charms, so yeah. I saw you and Miss Parkin as you were running from the Ravenclaw common room. It's a long story. Sorry, Professor Flitwick.
Oh.
Are you and Miss Parkin responsible for the mess that was left behind? It was only Skye! You know what? Yeah, Skye and I cast spells to overturn things.
Mm-hmm.
Not true. That was all my idea. Srahi wanted to stop me from casting the knockback jinx. Oh. Well, good thing I didn't throw her under the bus. Skye, I didn't see you come in. I'd have taken the blame with you. Appreciate it, but I can't let you do that when it's my fault.
Oh.
I'm disappointed that the two of you were sneaking into the Ravenclaw common room at all. You know that's against the rules to be in the common room of another house.
Mm-hmm.
We had good intentions. We were looking for a stolen item. You can explain while we review. Review what?
Oh.
The responsible use of the knockback jinx. She did it. Wait, just hold on. I thought someone was calling me out there. Yeah, okay. There's nothing wrong about a window. Knockback jinx is useful in dueling, not in common room. Perhaps there are other ways to go about finding a missing item. I've got a theory who took Sarai's missing comet broom. Got to knock a few things around to properly search for a broom. Skye, I swear to God. I've reason to suspect that Ravenclaw knows where the comet is. I'd like a proper missing room of my own. We can't find the common room. I did not teach you the knockback thing for mischievous purposes. That is literally the only thing the knockback jinx has ever used for. Utter the incantation flipendo only when you must. Practical and defensive. Professor Flitwick, I don't think you've ever seen anybody use the knockback jinx properly. Literally the only reason knockback jinx is used is when for mischief. That's enough review, and I've heard enough of your explanations for upending the Ravenclaw common room. We'll stay out of the Ravenclaw common room from now on, Professor Flitwick.
Oh.
Right, because the broom isn't hidden there. Perhaps the broom hasn't been hidden at all. Perhaps it has actually been misplaced or simply lost. It's something to consider. That's what I tried to tell Skye, but she didn't listen to me.
Oh.
Consider staying out of trouble, please, or I won't excuse you so easily next time. Thank you, Professor. You've got Quidditch practice now, but we'll think about your lost broom theory. Lost broom. I've got some thoughts, all right. Skye, please don't get any ideas. And now we shall practice. Make your way to the Quidditch pitch. Orion. Alright, Snitch. I see you. Please don't make me play another friendly. Yep. Screw this. I hate this uniform so much, man. I swear to goodness. Did you see Skye's new broom? Yes. What model of a broom is Raz flying these days? I'm asking my mom and dad for comment 260 for Christmas. You know what I want for Christmas? I have no idea. I actually don't want anything. I mean, I'm still saving up for a drawing tablet. Your comment 260 is getting quite a lot of attention.
Oh.
So you'll have your comment soon too. We'll show Erika Rath. You still think Rath is to blame for taking the broom? Yeah, she's our fiercest rival on quite possibly Hogwarts' fiercest Quidditch team. Ah. Rather clever too, so I hear. Makes sense she'd be looking for ways to slow us down.
Oh.
Especially when we need speed to win our second house match. Rath would know who we're facing next. What about Flitwick's theory about the broom just being lost or misplaced? Can you really think about that?
Ah.
Rubbish! That's what I think of that theory. Yes, Orion, we can see you're here.
Yeah.
What theory is that? What theory is it that you are calling into question?
Oh.
Let's practice, just forget it.
Yeah.
But when we forget it, we fail to remember. Oh my god, Orion, we know that! I might be faster if we just tell Orion what's going on, Skye.
Yeah.
Yes, perhaps I can help. Consider me the captain of your troubles. Please begin. Captain of your troubles makes absolutely no sense whatsoever, but I'll take it. I see your new broom, Skye Parkin, and in your new broom I see... What? Trahi is already smashing at Quidditch with the comet, unstoppable. I want to be a beater! I'd be honored to have a broom of my own, especially a comet, because my mom wouldn't get me one. Changing to the comet broom. Skye really wanted to give me that comet broom that's been in our family for years. Begs the question that this is all in year 2. It happens in year 2 and year 3. But in year 3, when we sneak in... Year 4! No, when do we... I forgot when we sneak into the Forbidden Forest for the first time. I think it's year 4. Yes, it's year 4. In year 4, when we sneak into the Forbidden Forest for the first time, we borrow a broom. We can borrow Mirula's broom or Andre's broom. But if this is year 2, we should already have a broom by then. You don't need to borrow. I see. What do you see? My face?
Yeah.
I see that it is time for our practice to begin.
Oh.
I had a feeling this would get us nowhere.
Yeah.
Patience, my friends. Practice first. We will have our second house match. We have a second house match to prepare for.
Yeah.
My thoughts about you, your missing broom will follow. Yeah, let's practice first. Oh, please don't make me do another friendly. Damn it. Cut this out too. Alright, match is over. Match is over. Let's get down to the point. I always see things more clearly after an inspiring team practice. So, do you think Rath stole the missing broom or someone else? Or do you think it's just lost or misplaced?
Yeah.
I think Sarahi Silvers that we can recover your lost broom. I shall reveal my plan soon. Can you reveal it now? 2 gems! Damn it! The mystery of the missing comet continues, but now your Quidditch crew is on the case. Oh my god, we call them literally our Quidditch crew. Have I mentioned that I love these guys? Check out the store for this animated. Yeah, this is that sweater that I lost in House Pride twice. I lost this in the House Pride twice. No thanks, I don't need it. I was never like very fond of it anyway. Oh wait. Snapshot. There's Erika Rath. Yeah, I just wanted to do the snapshots. I should update my patented Quidditch quiz. Okay. Where does my house stand after the first round of the house matches? One more person. Yeah. Did you hear? The Quidditch house rankings are in. And nothing. Hey, Pen. I'm sorry that I won't have much time to catch up before Quidditch practice, Penny. Orion has promised to reveal his plan about how to find my missing comet broom.
Huh?
I didn't even know you had a broom until I heard it was gone. It was a gift from Skye, but it disappeared before she could give it to me. But if Orion thinks he knows how to find it, why not tell you at once? Let's just say I am finding my Quidditch friends have unusual approaches to tackling mysteries. Is that frustrating for you? You're quite experienced with mysteries. Nah, it's alright. No, it's alright. Perhaps I learned something from their odd methods that I can apply to the cursed worlds. And I'm lucky to have teammates who are so eager for me to have a broom of my own. Not just any broom, a comet broom. They're special. Skye showed me that she can broom drift on a comet broom. If we find my comet, I can broom drift too. Skye says it would give our Hufflepuff an advantage in second house match. And what about the rumor going around that Erika Rat stole the broom? I was hoping you could tell me more, Penny. I've only just learned it's become a rumor at Hogwarts. I don't think she did it. Nothing. I'm going to be using snapshot mode so much, I swear. How can you be chatting about anything other than Quidditch house rankings? That's a long story. Hey? Skye thinks Rat took the broom that Skye had wanted to give me as a gift, whatever. It's important to me and to the team that we find the missing comet broom. Comet brooms are very special. They have a patented breaking charm. Yes, I know. Orion seems to think the broom is lost. I also seem to think the broom is lost. Skye thinks it is stolen. Perhaps Skye is spreading the rumor. Skye is flying on a brand new Comet 260 now. You should see it. We already did that. Oh, we are telling this to Penny. Everyone is talking about this rumor. In potions class? I'm just going to eavesdrop. I'm the first to hear most rumors, at least I try to be. No, I think Penny is first to hear. So everyone is spreading this rumor about Rat stealing my broom, but we don't know who started it. Perhaps it's Skye who started it, or perhaps Rat does have the broom and someone knows let it slip. I'm not even reading properly anymore. Skye really is convinced that Rat took the comet, but Orion believes the broom is just lost. Which theory do you believe? The comet is lost. I'm with Orion. I think the comet was lost or misplaced somehow. Then perhaps if you keep searching, it'll turn up. I hope you find it soon. Skye told me the comet's breaking charm can make a difference between a win and a loss. And now Hufflepuff is the one to be tied for first place after the first house matches. I've been so caught up in the mystery of the missing broom, I hadn't checked the house rankings. Then please find the broom so you can get your head back into the game. Sometimes I forget I'm talking to a Quidditch superfan. I am a superfan of you too, Sarahi. Why are we not talking to Rowan here? And I'd love to help you find the broom, but I promised Hagrid I'd help him wrangle some lost crab pups. I've got to go to Quidditch practice anyway. We literally just practiced. What the hey? Good luck finding the comet broom. Thanks. Good luck finding the crab pups. Whoa. Hey. Guess we know what Erika Rat thinks of the rumor that she stole your comet broom. Ow. Excuse me, Erika Rat. Ow. Seriously, I'm just going to lie there. I mean, I swear to goodness, man. Let's just go. We literally just practiced. I can't find my beater's bat. You think Rat stole it? Oh, come on! Now everyone is accusing Rat of random things. Hey, I found an extra beater's bat in the changing room. Give it to him! Have you heard the rumors about the missing broom? Oh, please, yaar. Can you people... Never mind. I wish you'd been there to see it. Rat knocked me down and just kept on going. Erika... Erika, Rat knows who you are now. Were there any doubt? Smashing. Then it's working. Was working. I've been the one telling everyone how Rat stole your comet broom. Skye! Skye, why would you start spreading a rumor all around Hogwarts? Because that's how you find a broom. Haven't you ever started a rumor to break a curse? No, I'm quite sure I haven't. The mind of Skye Parkin fascinates me. Listen, we're tied for first place right now. To stay there, we have to speed up the broom investigation. Had to get Rat's attention. Let her know we're onto her so that she'll return the comment broom. But we don't know yet if there's any truth to the rumor. Right, but at least now things are getting interesting. Here's how. Skye, I swear to goodness, you're just... You're kind of making enemies. And I'm scared of that. I would rat know for you over if she were innocent. There was the other ways to find this broom, man. I sense that we are in danger of losing our focus and balance. Oriendo, not town. Orien, not now, please. Rats may hold this against our whole team. I am confused about what's going on, but I'm not questioning it. Point is, let's not fear the wrath of Wrath. You'll be broom drifting right past her on your comet broom soon enough. Orien, you said you had a plan to find the broom. Please lay it on me. Indeed. And we shall speak of the lost comet again after practice, which we must begin now. We literally just practiced. I'm cutting this out too. Okay, match over. Now what? I hope Quidditch practice has provided everyone with more clarity. If by more clarity you mean no more shooting star splinters, then yes, I hope we find this comet soon because I have a splinter again, probably. From the side face, that's what I all I can tell. I'm sticking with my Erika Rat theory, but I'd still like to hear Orien's plan.
Yeah.
Let us all meet in the Quidditch stand shortly. There we shall find the missing comet pool. Please, no. Oh, thank you. Let's just go. No, I do not want it. Huh. What does this look like on snapshot mode? I love snapshot mode and I think I've said that enough. Alright, we're here, Orien. Now what? Mm. Now we search for the lost comet broom. So you still think the broom is lost and that it's here somewhere in the Quidditch stands. Indeed, if it is fated to be here. Huh? Fate doesn't help in Quidditch championships, but finding Sarahi a better broom just might.
Yeah.
What about you, Sarahi? Do you believe in fate? I believe only in myself. I believe in coincidence. Yeah, I kinda do. I believe in fate. I have a purpose at Hogwarts. My brother, the cursed waltz, even Quidditch, it's all connected. No, it's not. That's not what I meant when I took this option, but you know what? Never mind.
Yeah.
We are all connected, and I believe we shall connect with your lost broom.
Uh-huh.
Well, I believe if you're going to search through all the Quidditch stands, you better get started. Though I doubt Rat hit the broom here. Let's split up so we can cover more ground.
Yeah.
No, we shall all search together from right where we are. Huh? What? Search while we all stand in place? How do you mean? Follow your mind and follow my lead. I don't get it. Orien, what are you saying? I am confusion. Oh! He believes it is lost and he is trying to get Skye to remember like where was the last... Not sure what I... Yeah. He's like doing that thing that police do sometimes. Okay, where it was the last... Where did you last leave it? Eyes open or closed? How does one search their mind for a broom? If you are talking, you are not searching. We are confusion. We are both confusion only. My mind is telling me that this search isn't working. Yeah. I kind of agree with Skye here. I mean... Confusion. We still have to balance on one leg to search our minds in a room. Please don't make me do that. Yeah, we are both confusion. Your broom will find you. This is a broom, not a horse. I mean, if it was a horse, then it would be make sense because horses actually are very smart. What's a horse got to do with anything? Why am I talking about horses? Orien, you are like filling us with confusion. you are filled with confusion. Like, it is supposed to be you are filled with determination, but no, we are filled with confusion. So I get the feeling neither of you have much experience with searching for things. We're chasers. We don't search, we chase. Just because the broom is not here does not mean we did not find it. Huh? That's exactly what it means, Orion. I actually agree with Skye here. Perhaps we should take a break and regroup. Right, play some more Quidditch and then get back to the case of the missing comet. No, that's not what I meant. Case of the missing comet? I've got to get in on this. Murphy, seriously? How did you even... Never mind. Murphy, what are you doing here? Joining a case-solving Quidditch crew, I think. Searching for rooms and for answers. Unraveling mysteries and more. Yes, we get it. The only thing the three of you are missing, is you, patience, the comet group, strategy, of course. Follow me to the Great Hall. Like, of course, his answer to everything is strategy. Okay, part two. Huh. They're good at Quidditch but bad at mysteries. You, Skye, Orion, and Murphy embark on a comet caper. This has been a long recording. Strategy session delayed. I've got to school a first year on wizard chess. A first year? Like, the minute I thought that we are not getting any of these waiting times, I do get one. And that is good. I had a 43-minute recording. I need to stop. Okay, I'm done waiting. Strategize with friends. Come on. Any crab pups running through here? No. Will we ever find these crab pups? No. No, Amira, you will. I was just joking. Everyone is complimenting my face paint today. Good. No other comments? Then let's go. So I was in my commentary box and I saw the three of you in the stands doing nothing. And then I thought, what are the odds that the three of you would be in the stands doing nothing? And then I calculated the odds to be only 8.4%. And then you decided to join us. I did. So you say you were searching for your minds for a missing comet broom? Orion's idea, of course. Brooms have been found in less likely places than the far reaches of one psyche Skye. I didn't understand what word you just said, but okay. I challenge you to provide statistics on that, Orion. Won't our time be better spent searching? Murphy, you said we needed a strategy to find the missing comet. Of course we do. I'll break it down for you by the numbers. As less numbers as possible, please. Oh man, this is gonna be a long clicky. Why am I doing this? Because I can. Yep. There's a 63.7% chance that the most obvious strategy is the best strategy, huh? Take the castle's number of rooms and divide it by the number of brooms. Oh my god! The sooner we find the broom, the sooner we can stop looking. Would the broom be hiding in plain sight? What are the odds that the common room was stolen? Guys, anger, baby. Let's stop talking and start moving. Many brooms would get be lost at found at Hogwarts. You know what, I'm just going to hurry up and click. There. I spammed click and I did it. I can put my broom searching calculations on a scroll if it'll help. But to find the broom, we must keep our minds clear and uncluttered by calculations. That I agree with. Or we could stop strategizing and philosophizing and just go flippendo some more stuff until it turns up. No! Which do you think is the best search approach, Sarahi? Strategic, mindful, physical? Mindful. I think Orion's idea about keeping our minds open to all possibilities in a focused way is the best approach. Am I the captain or are you? Or are we the captain now? Please shut up! You confuse me. Blimey, I'm about ready to flip it on this table. Please don't flip the table, Skye. The odds of that going well aren't high, Skye. Listen, we make a fine team on the pitch. If we, even if we disagree, we can't find a way to work as a team now. Don't you dare, Erika, don't you dare. No, I swear to God, no. Don't just look at me like that. I think she's mad, yeah. She's mad at Skye for starting the rumors. Okay, I get it. Can you two please stop now? Look at this. So many talented Hogwarts Quidditch players all together. Along with myself, I'm the completely impartial Quidditch commentator. Unbiased and objective. Neutral and knowledgeable. Fair yet fervent. Forthright yet... Murphy, we get it. Heard any good rumors lately, Rath? You can't just go around looking at people like that. Do you think it's that Erika Rath doesn't like to talk, or Skye has been doing much of the talking lately? Yes, Skye started the rumor that Rath stole the missing cupboard room. I think she's mad about it. Only because I believe it to be true. That's what that staring contest was all about. How did you not know McNally? The whole school is talking about it. I was in the box all day practicing my silky smooth commentary voice. You need to practice that. If anything should motivate us to work as a team now, it was the glares of those Ravenclaw players. Right, we need to be united front. I mean, I die as well. You know my impartiality is just for show. Now let's find out what happened to the comment room so we can get back to what we're best at together. Sharing wisdom. Spreading rumors. Excellent hair. No! Quidditch! Too bad we can't approach this mystery like we do a Quidditch match. What if we can? Murphy, what does that mean? It means I know where we all need to go next if we're going to find our room. How? I don't get it. To be honest, Sarahi just sat there and said nothing, right? To be honest, if I were there, I'd be like, okay, we get the point, you two are mad at each other. Now please, stop this. To approach this mystery like a Quidditch match, we need to start where the team starts, the changing room. Alright, I'm on board with this so far. And before a match, you often review Quidditch moves on this very blackboard, correct? Indeed, but the blackboard is empty. Wait until you see what Murphy can do with an empty blackboard. Expected. Huh? This is Sky! And of course MC has got nothing! Because... reasons. This is McNally or in Erika. And of course MC's got nothing, but that's okay. This is the best drawing ever. It's brilliant. I think it's brilliant. I never quite know what you'll conjure up next, Murphy. That's exactly what my mom says. What is that we're looking at? We are looking at McLily. Very funny looking stick figures. A record of what we know about Sarahi's missing comet broom. Now we can review the major moves like a team would before a Quidditch match. The crew on that end, is that supposed to be us? Yes, you can't expect me to be a brilliant Quidditch commentator and brilliant sketch artist. Ooh, I can do sketches. I'm not brilliant, but I'm okay. You can be all things if you believe. I just realized I've got no hair or face. It's a work in progress. Yeah, I saw. So then what was supposed to come next? The four of us victoriously holding your comet broom, winning the match to put it in Quidditch terms. A visualization, I see. Then I know what must come next if we are to win this match. A moment of evocation. Oh, please. Oh, yeah. Seriously? That was not the time. Yeah, we have no hair or face. Think Orion knows all these moments of vivification are just pep talks. He knows. A Quidditch without a broom is like a mystery without a clue. One Sky Silver plus one Comet Broom equals many Quidditch victories. There is only one Sky Silver, okay? I enjoy Orion's Orionism. Yeah, this is. Let's go, we've got a snitch. I mean, a thief to catch. I wonder if I can use Quidditch to solve all of Hogwarts mysteries. Nope, you can't. Nope. We may not possess the comment room, but we possess the potential to find it. I swear, we are doing what now?
Hey.
I know I certainly feel better after that moment of evocation. I don't. Now it's just wasting time we could be using to trap Erika Rath into a confession. Though that might be complicated if it turns out she didn't steal the comet room, so let's not jump to conclusions again. I'd put chances at less than 1.1% that Rath would cop to a crime she didn't commit. Remember, it is possible that there has been no crime committed at all. Things are not always as they seem. Do you know something that we don't, Orion? I know that a cat is only a cat until it is a cauldron.
Whoa.
You think someone's transfigured something as special as a comet room into an ordinary cat?
Whoa.
Or an ordinary cauldron? Cats and cauldrons are special in their own ways. But we may be onto something. The idea of things not always being as they seem.
Oh.
So you're thinking if we can't turn up the comet room, let's transfigure something into a comet room? No, the opposite. Well, I didn't quite say that.
Oh.
Smashing, let's try it.
Hey.
Brilliant, off to the transfiguration classroom. Dude, that's not the way it works. I don't think that's the way it works. We can't transfigure stuff into a broom, but we can. I don't think that, yeah, this is going to be an awful fail. Yep, we are about to have an epic fail here. So what shall we try to transfigure into a comet room? Whatever it is, we'll have to do it quickly. Professor McGonagall will be teaching a class soon.
Oh.
Let's transfigure McGonagall's chair. It's made of wood and broomsticks are made of wood.
Yeah.
But McGonagall will know her chair is missing. Then let's get an owl in here. Owls fly and they're fast. I do need a fast flying broom if we're to defeat the fastest owl at Hogwarts in our next house match.
Yeah.
But aren't owls to be transfigured into opera classes? That's an actual lesson. One less pair of opera glasses in the world, who cares?
Ew.
Those who require focus at the opera shall care. Yeah, he's got a point. We really ought to hurry up before McGonagall arrives. I'd have a run about and transfiguration 10 minutes. I'd have run about and transfigured 10 things by now, but McNally wants to be strategic about it.
Yeah.
With your marks, would have transfigured 10 things by now, Skye? Listen, we need to stick together as a team. Approach the mystery as we do a Quidditch match, remember? Indeed, we have strayed from our path. What does one need to play Quidditch?
Uh-huh.
Easy. Brooms, hoops, quaffle, bludgers, bats, snitch.
Hey.
There's the Quidditch connection. Goldfinch into golden snitch is a transfiguration lesson. Is it? Smashing. This is definitely not a mystery solving technique I'd recommend. This is coming from a curse breaker, okay?
Uh-huh.
Nothing mysterious about it. Once we do it, you'll have a comet broom, Sarahi. We have come this far together. Let us together transfigure a goldfinch into a comet broom. I don't think that's possible. That's not possible. No, that's not. This is going to be an epic fail. There's no lesson for transfiguring a goldfinch into a broom. Will this work? No! Just keep thinking comet. Okay. Yeah. Just keep saying comet. Yeah, our friends are malfunctioning. The goldfinch after every match and practice. Does this bird need a breaking charm? No, it doesn't. And this is not going to work. Yeah, I'm just going to spam click and until we're done. Okay, we're done. Now what? This is not going to work. This is going to be such a big fail, and then McGonagall is going to punish us probably. What the? Yep. What happened? That's not a comet broom.
Oh.
Nor is it a goldfinch, and I have never seen Orion look worried before. I think we've transfigured the goldfinch into an actual comet. How do we stop it? See, I knew it. I told you guys this was going to be an epic fail. Does anybody listen to me? Thank you. What do you have to say for yourselves? Thank you. Sorry. Thank you. You really saved us, Professor McGonagall. I saved this goldfinch. You were fortunate to be in its vicinity. Sometimes we are all goldfinches. Orion, not helping. Pardon me, Mr. Amari. What Orion means is we were trying to turn the bird into a broom. Bird into a broom? I told her it's not... It's a long story. All of your stories are long stories, Mr. McNally. The four of you can explain on our way to Professor Dumbledore's office. See, I knew it. I knew this was going to happen. Can you people listen? If only I'd listened to virtually anyone. Like, these four are like... That joke. If only I listen to virtually anyone. You people need to stop. You need to like start listening to me sometimes. I am a curse breaker. I do mysteries and these things all the time. It is a habit. So, you know, please stop doing stupid things. You don't like get to go to Dumbledore's office too often. So I thought like might as well. But you know what? Not worth it. Madam Hooch, what are you doing here? Where is the music? Are we off the Quidditch team? I'll be grounded forever. Professor McGonagall has informed me of your dangerous antics in the Transfiguration classroom. My understanding is that it involves a comet broom that has gone missing from the Quidditch changing room. That's when Professor Dumbledore called me. Madam Hooch and I would like to hear what has happened in your own words. I've got this. I'm a wizard with words. Thank you, Mr. McNally, but let's allow everyone to do the talking because you talk too much. And we need kind of a short and compact explanation here. Like, look at this. I knew this would happen. These two look like they're talking at the same time. That makes me get hard to understand. This mystery would not exist if comet rooms did not exist. Orion, that's stupid. This all started with the splinter from a shooting star broom. Can you please tell us if we're still on the Quidditch team? This guy is like, at least I'm not getting into trouble over a cursed world, right? That was a joke. I found an incriminating broom. Skye, please don't. You got a Quidditch mystery? Not a Hogwarts mystery. Roll credits! I have no idea what that means, actually. Let's just say we're working on the case of the missing comet. I didn't factor this office visit into our strategy. The missing comet room was a gift from Skye to me. Can a comet room be lost if it's stolen stolen if lost? We do not yet know. Oh my god. Now MC is just disappointed. At least this is not a cursed world. We've got a Quidditch mystery, not a Hogwarts mystery. Yeah. This is a Quidditch mystery. This is not the game. This is just a Quidditch mystery. Okay, that makes no sense. That is quite a story. The situation was clearer before your explanation. Huh? Talking isn't what we do best.
Yeah.
Speak for yourself, Skye. Thought I just did.
Yeah.
We each have our unique talents. It seems that the only thing that can be agreed upon is that the missing comet broom is yours, Miss Silvers. Yes, it was meant to be mine. Then would you say this misadventure is your responsibility? Take the blame, pass the blame, share the blame. share, man, because it's not like we did this ourselves. We're all in this together. It's no one witch or wizard's fault.
Uh-huh.
I respect your commitment to rising and falling as a team. I agree that our commitment to your mystery teammates is admirable. Mystery teammates, it has quite a ring to it. However, we are still faced with the dilemma of what to do about the case of the missing comet. Yes, what's your strategy, Professor Dumbledore? Put a few more wizards and witches on the case? That's the stupidest question ever. On the contrary, it is time for the case to be dropped. What? Give up? Your conduct in the transfiguration classroom suggests that to continue could bring danger to yourself or others. I was so close to having a broom of my own. You are not the first students to misplace a broom at Hogwarts. But if the common broom were stolen by a rival, let's say, please guys, shut up about it. That is a serious accusation for which we have no proof, Miss Parkin. Unfortunately, it is possible that the broom may never turn up. Despite your exemplary, if misguided, teamwork. So you're disbanding our mystery team? Be glad we are not disbanding your Quidditch team.
Oh.
Well, at least we're still on the Quidditch team. So I'm still in the team? Smashing. Thank you, Professor Dumbledore. Thank you, Madam Hooch. And so let us put the mystery to rest and get to practice. The Quidditch pitch awaits us. I'm going to get another splinter, aren't I? Yeah. Well, never mind. Where is the music, man? We need more practice before our second house match. I hear you've been off solving a mystery. I do that literally all the time. Has anyone heard the rumors about Erika Rath? Please shut up about it. Already talked to McNally? We'll meet after practice to figure out our next move. Next move? Dumbledore and Hood said to drop the case of the missing comet. Gave up on finding your comet room? No way. Oh my god, these people never listen. Skye and I agree upon a few things, but we are in agreement that this mystery team shall carry on. Brilliant, I'm in. Brilliant. Then count me in too, of course. And just like that, we're back on the case. Oh my god, this is going to be so bad. You shared the blame among us in Dumbledore's office. Any one of us would have done the same. We are a true team. I was hoping that all of you would feel that way.
Yeah.
And now let us practice. We have a broom to find. Another practice? Yep, I'm just gonna cut it out. Nope. Okay, match over. That was a gripping practice just now.
Yeah.
And while you were playing, I solved the comet broom mystery. While you were commentating on our friendly who found the comet broom? Not exactly, but the latest edition of which broomstick arrived.
Yeah.
Allow me to explain. Oh my god, my energy! Damn it. What? Is it wise to believe everything we read? I've had a subscription to which broomstick ever since I could read. The editors at which broomstick test ride brooms and review them. See. Look at the advertisements for all the new broom models. It's like cars. Wow, there's so much to learn about broomsticks. You cannot judge this publication by its cover. Of course my family subscribed to which broomstick. We're Parkins. In the market for a broom, which broomstick is the ex... I'm not reading. No. No. And my energy is out. Almost. Now I have to stop the recording just to get more energy. Oh, dueling club arrived. I understand which broomstick is a great resource for learning about brooms, but how does it help us?
Yeah.
Until we recover the missing comet broom, or perhaps steal it back from Erika Rath, please shut up.
Yeah.
We can find you a broom of your own in this magazine. Smashing idea, perhaps not a comet broom, but a better broom than the one you've been borrowing. Indeed, quality second-hand brooms are bought, sold and traded all of the time. Thank you, but I can't even afford a second-hand broom from this magazine. You're our strategy wizard, McNally. Got a plan for that? Can't afford. We have like so many galleons. MC, please note that MC is rich enough to have her own vault at Gringotts. And she pays for the butterbeers that she gets her friends and all that. Of course we can afford this. My strategy was that we could somehow become wealthy and I hadn't worked out the details. We are wealthy in the ways that matter. Orion is right. All of you had already done so much for me. You just apparated here. Srahi, we found your missing comet broom.
Whoa.
You did? That's brilliant, you Spenny. Not exactly.
No.
I think you all ought to come with us to me garden. Your comet broom caper comes to a surprising end, but there is another surprise in store for you. I'll have to stop. Yes, I know there's a dueling club. I can see it. I have to stop. I need to get more energy. Yes, I know about the daily rewards. My friends told me. Yes, I know. I know. Wow, I'll have to stop anyway. Okay, I'll get more energy and, you know. So the point of was that since we couldn't find the broom Skye was giving me, they were working on getting me a new broom. But nobody can afford it. But they found my broom. I got more energy and this is Hagrid's garden. This is actually kind of new. It is new, not kind of new. Let's see what it looks like. Wow! This is beautiful! Now this is nice, man. That is so nice. I hope we can come here like whenever because I love this. Okay, enough with the snapshot mode. Let's just Crappies! So cute! Aww. That's the Comet 220 Skye wanted to give me. Oh, the puppies destroyed it. That's the one. What happened? Here's what we think happened. Oh, guys, you remember that one puppy who was running across the field when Skye was showing us the broom drifting? That puppy went into the changing room and dragged, and there must have been other puppies and dragged out the, you know, the broom. You remember I was pointing at those puppies who were running across the field? Yeah. Oh my god, but can you be mad at these little faces? No. The cup pups here are teeth in. Use your broom like a chew toy. Yeah, I assumed. So this is what's left of a park and family hand-me-down. So me pups weren't lost, they were hiding. I fear the comet broom is beyond repair. Yeah. The lost puppies were here chewing on your broom the whole time. Look at this little one. Seriously. Look at these babies. Can you be mad at them? No. No, no, no. You cannot be mad at them. And if you're mad at them, you have no soul. So Erika Rath is innocent. Yeah, I told you. Yeah, the usual Tumblr email that I get every week. We think the crab puppies dragged the broom to the garden. Yeah. This is what's left of Park and family. Hand me down. Lookie looks so happy. Those crab pups dragged the broom all the way here? What a team. The crab pups had the comet room. You can't be mad at these little faces, man. Just look at this one rolling on the ground, my favorite. I would want to hug them even though they destroyed a comet broom. I want to hug them. I knew the whole time Erika was innocent. My brothers will never believe me when I tell them how crap pup swiped the comet. But I suppose Erika Raj will have no trouble believing it. One must appreciate the resourcefulness of these ambitious crap pups. United in purpose, united as pups. They're so cute! They're so cute! What they have done to this comet broom is rather beautiful in its own primal way. Look at this one!
Huh?
So, Rai, what's he saying? Complete nonsense, Hagrid. Don't trouble yourself with it. Orion is glad you found your lost crap pups, Hagrid. I am too. Even if they did chew up the comet broom that was to be mine. Sorry about that. When Penny told me you were missing a broom, we put the pieces together.
No.
Pieces of the story, I mean. Fred, there's no putting the broom back together. It's no one's fault. How can we blame these adorable crap pups who needed something to teeth for? I want to hug them. And to drag the broom all the way from the changing room to hide in Hagrid's garden. Which pup came up with the idea? How did they organize? Who led the way? Like, look, he has one in his lap. What obstacles did they face? How did they persevere? It's a classic underdog story. Not so different from your own story, Sarahi. You were an underdog going into Quidditch tryouts. Isn't that right, Topaz? 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 I think my puppy is mad at me. I don't actually have a puppy, I'm just talking about Topaz. Topaz is my puppy. But not really. You know what I mean. I suppose these crabs have and I have a bit in common. Except they had a comet broom of their own for a while. Sorry, Srahi. Perhaps I'm just not meant to have a comet broom of my own, or to ever learn how to broom drift. On the bright side, we have closed the case of the missing comet. Yes, now we can get back to focusing on Quidditch. This mystery has been solved. Ah, mysteries. They are so mysterious. Dude, there's a reason they're called mysteries.
Hey.
Well, I've had a brilliant time being on a mystery team with you lot.
Uh-huh.
If you had to pick the better mystery mates, would it be the our mystery team or your usual crew of mates? I'd choose them. I'd still choose my usual crew of mates for most mysteries. This crew were at our best when it's about Quidditch.
Uh-huh.
Quidditch is the most important thing. And we don't exactly crack the case. Yes, you'd have to work on some of your mystery solving strategies before heading to the cursed world together. If it's a strategy problem, there's a 97.7% chance I can help with that. All mysteries aside, there's a 100% chance that my time as Hogwarts has been made better by each of you. Then let us mark the demise of the comet with a celebration of friendship.
Uh-huh.
Quidditch is what brought us together.
Hey.
So let's party on the Quidditch pitch. Are you sure? Look at these! Oh my god! No. I am putting on snapshot mode. Are you seeing these puppies? That is like so adorable. That crappy playing with the puff skin. Guys, seriously, these puppies are going to kill me with cuteness. This is the cutest thing ever and I cannot handle all this cuteness. I cannot handle the cuteness, man. I have to go. Oh, this is the last set. Good, because I'm tired. Meet your friends, because something is happening. Hola. Skye's broom. Hi everyone, and Madam Hooch too. Am I late to this Quidditch party? What's going on?
Oh.
Surprise! Here's your brand new Comet 260 broom. Hey. Wait a minute. This is not Skye's broom. This is our broom. My Comet 260. I thought it was yours.
Huh?
That is a surprise. My comet 260 is in the changing room. This is your comet 260, your very own broom. My broom and a comet 260? How? But how? Hagrid and I believed it was necessary, so we made it happen. I felt so bad about Mikra Pups taking Skye's gift, yes? I just had to do something. But I could have kept playing Quidditch on that old borrowed broom. What made you believe this was necessary? Not what, it's who made them believe. Me. Right, me too. And I as well. Oh my god. Your Quidditch mates told me what talent you brought to the Hufflepuff team. And I expect nothing less. But when they told me what you've brought into their lives, the friendship, the camaraderie, I have no idea what that word means. What that word means, the teamwork. And that is what Quidditch at Hogwarts is all about. Enjoy your new broom, Miss Silvers. Fly safely. We leave your kids to your party. Have fun. Safe and responsible fun. Thank you again, Hagrid. Thank you, Madam Hooch. Yeah, we have a broom. How can I ever thank all of you? I know how. Take your first broom on its first flight. Indeed, a rising star upon a comet. Let's see it. Hey. What's taking you so long? Hurry up and take off. All right. Go and get your comet, Skye. Let's fly. You first. You've already watched me broom drift. You try it. But how? You speed up, then brake fast, then drift to the side. You've got the comet's Horton cage braking charm now. You can do it. You'll see. All right. Here I go. I'm so excited! Even though I have no idea what's going on, I'm still excited. That's so adorable! Smashing, Sahi! You did it, you broom drifted! This comet broom, it flies so fast and breaks so well! That was incredible, Sahi! You were a Quidditch phenom before, but now I'm speechless. Me, speechless. Indeed, your broom drifting was a Quidditch sight to behold. Thank you again for all that you've done to help me get my very first broom, a brand new Comet 260. Just in time too. Up next, our second house match against Gryffindor, fastest house at Hogwarts. Our new comets will give us an edge. Let's fly our brooms to victory. This chaser is ready to fly this Comet 260 all the way to the Quidditch Cup for Hufflepuff and for my friends. Yay! This is so cute, man! Oh man, we should just hug them! Why aren't we just hugging them? Like, hug them! Come on! I think this is in Quidditch. Techniques, broom drifting. And we have one broom now. Yeah. Plus 5 energy, what? Alright, but that was so cute! All of that. Never mind. That was so cute, man. All of it was so cute. Man, this was so fulfilling. I have not felt this fulfilled by a Hogwarts mystery thing in a while. Okay. Guess we gotta go now. This was so great. Like, okay, guys, I hope you enjoyed this episode of Hogwarts Mystery. I am going to record another episode of Undertale soon. Maybe tomorrow or day after tomorrow, I guess. Depending upon when I get time. And guys, do please share my Undertale video. I am really enjoying Undertale and I really want others to enjoy it. If you have never seen Undertale before, if you just come to my channel for Hogwarts Mystery and you are seeing Undertale for the very first time and feel that you are not interested, that's fine. But I really suggest that you watch the gameplays of Undertale. It doesn't necessarily have to be mine. But I really do. Recommending. I'm really recommending that you watch the Undertale or play it yourself. It is really great. It is really cute and I love it. So I hope you guys enjoyed and well, bye-bye.